Here's five different types of virtual events in 5 minutes or less. The first is shop local, but online. The Pierre Area Chamber use Shop Where I Live, and the Los Altos Chambers use Gifted. Basically, you can set up or partner with an e-commerce platform, brand it to your city, and invite your local businesses to become vendors on it. Businesses would essentially pay for the right to be on it, but they would conduct all of the fulfillment details. So no, the chamber's not selling stuff on their behalf. This gives customers one place to shop online while still supporting local businesses. And depending on how you set it up, you might be able to make some non-dues revenue from it. For the second virtual event, I want to throw out the obvious. Webinars, membership orientations, any one-to-many presentation you can host on Zoom or a similar platform. However, I want to bring it up because I strongly recommend you record these and upload them to your YouTube or other platform so you can continue to promote and utilize these now on-demand events. These are now available at any time for my members whenever they can prioritize watching them, and I only had to do the work once. Number three is virtual award shows. I'm going to briefly go over some things I saw some chambers doing, but first, a message from my sponsor.
Hey, Brandon Burton with Chamber Chat Podcast. Have you given any thought to the benefits a podcast could have for your chamber while also providing great impact to your community? I would like to help you get started in the podcasting space by providing you with my free Chamber Podcasting Guide. Please visit chamberchatpodcast.com/pivot to request your free copy of the Chamber Podcasting Guide and learn why your chamber should be podcasting.
During COVID, many chambers opted to move their awards banquet virtual. Some still offered food, some didn't. I like the ones that offered local gift cards and made an option for attendees to choose if they wanted it or not, because the few that didn't can still save you a little money because they were still charging the same price. Speaking of which, I recently learned that you can offer a restaurant an in-kind sponsorship by buying gift cards you would need anyways at half price, which is a win-win. Most of the award shows were streamed live, which I think was important. The live stream will really help make people watch at the designated time. While the recording is still available, they probably won't watch it if they don't think it's relevant to them. But the way they went live was different for everybody. I believe that the better produced ones had some paid assistance from local members, which if you can budget for it, makes a huge difference. These often had a mix of both live and recorded elements. While the winners and your usual PA announcements were live, the nomination videos, sponsor content, board message, and some other stuff were pre-recorded and edited, and then played live during the live stream. Some winners knew ahead of time, and some didn't. I thought this was especially cool to see the video switch to the Zoom room of the winning businesses so you could actually see their face as they won. On the other hand, you could invite just the winners to the in-person part to share the stage with the chamber staff. For links to these examples and more, click on the article link in the video description. Next is virtual speed networking, and honestly, I love it. It's a little more manageable for me as an introvert, but I also find it really efficient because I save time not having to travel, and you also can't get stuck with you-know-who. If you use a platform like Blitzer, it will automatically match your attendees one-on-one, so you don't have the extra work of trying to deal with Zoom breakout rooms. It will also automatically move each attendee to the next person in line when the time is up. And I love that part. If you haven't tried it yet, it's because you haven't been to Frank Kinney's Weekly Blitzer, and you need to. Lastly, I want to give a shout out to Lakeland Chamber, who hosted a virtual political hobnob using Excel events. The event provided an occasion to meet and greet local, state, and federal candidates and learn their views on the year's hot topics. Each candidate paid to participate and had their own booth where they could directly interact with their constituents. So what about you and your chamber? Let us know in the comments below what virtual events you like or plan to host. And also, if you could tell me what to do with my hands, that would be great.